Well guys, quick video this time on a repair on one of your carbon fiber tanks. Recently, when undoing my bottle, I realized there was a small failure. Normally, there's a check valve inside and it should stop releasing air once you screw it out far enough. But this time it didn't and it drained the whole bottle. What is happening? I think inside the valve there is an O-ring failing or something. So in this video, I'll quickly show you how to take the valve off and how to fix it again. Let's get going. Now, to undo the top part you see here, or the check valve itself, I made this little tool where you can use a small pin like this that matches up with the hole there. So it goes on like this. This goes into that little hole and it gives you the leverage you need to undo the valve itself. Now, for purpose of this video and for easy handling, I've loosened everything already, so it's easier for me to show it to you on camera. Nothing is glued, so you can just take it out like this. Of course, always make sure your bottle is empty, there is no pressure inside, so you don't hurt yourself. The valve comes out like this. Let's put the bottle and the tool to the side. This is how it looks, an O-ring that sits here and in the neck of the bottle to prevent the air from escaping. You can undo this brass part. Like so. Then you have a spring to push your valve forward. You have the valve itself. And I'll take a small Allen key. And as you can see, here is the failed O-ring. Probably it got pinched like this between the valve, and that's why the air rushes out and the valve can't close. And there, down in the bottom, you have the valve seat. Let's take the valve seat out quickly by carefully pushing it out like this. And this is the valve seat, and as you can see, the damaged O-ring managed to come out from here. This is damaged, and that's why probably all the air is rushing out. This, remove it. Let me quickly grab another one and reassemble everything. The O-ring that has to go onto the valve seat is a 4.5 by 1.5 NBR70. So take a little bit of lube on my finger. Lube the O-ring a little bit. Put it in place just like this. Then I'll take a pick like this. Insert it again. Gently pushing it into place. Make sure you're not damaging the conical part where the valve seat has to sit, because if you scratch this, then the seat won't seal properly. As so, put back in your valve seat like this. Of course, make sure all your parts are clean. The spring on top of it. And then the brass part can go back on. Like so. Clean all the parts. Reloop the O-ring a bit. Put them back over. I'll quickly go to my workbench, clamp it into the vise, and tighten this up with an M14, I believe it is, and then we can install it back into the bottle.
Put your bottle in the clamp, just slightly, doesn't have to be too tight, that you don't damage your bottle. Take a little bit of loop to put on the O-ring. Put the O-ring inside the neck like this. Take your valve. Screwing it on, making sure the O-ring stays nicely in place and you don't pinch it. Let me rotate it a little bit. Take my tool. Putting it in like this. And tightening it down, making sure you don't damage your carbon fiber. Like so.
So, as you could see, that was how quick and easy it is to fix this leak on my carbon fiber tank of my FX Impact. I hope this video could help you if you're experiencing the same problem as I am. It's not a big deal, just taking out the valve, replacing the O-ring, and that's it. Please consider liking and subscribing if you want to see more videos like this. I thank you for watching, and I hope to see you back next time. Bye.